So with caffeine, I'd say the main thing to think about there is that if it is one of the main things that comes up is that caffeine can stimulate the digestive tract and cause like diarrhea, looser bowel movements, that sort of thing. So essentially what it's doing is it's stimulating the gut to move food through faster, which you don't
Okay, becoming more
necessarily want.
hyperactive.
Yeah, you don't
Okay.
necessarily want the gut to be like be to have food moving through it so quickly, because if you do, you have less time to absorb your nutrients. Like if a patient is having looser stools, that means food is moving through more quickly, typically. And yeah, you just have less time. If you have less time spent in the digestive tract, then you're not absorbing your nutrients adequately, and that can lead to lower nutrient levels as well. So that's one concern that can come up. Also, a lot of things that contain caffeine, like coffee and tea, they contain a lot of other different compounds as well, which can actually bind to a lot of the minerals in our food and prevent us from absorbing them. So it's
Okay.
usually actually from a nutrition standpoint, better to not have like coffee or tea with a meal. But you'll also get people who, if they have coffee or tea on an empty stomach, it really upsets their stomach. So for some people, coffee and tea just don't work. Caffeine just doesn't work, doesn't sit well with them. For others, they find like it's this great digestive tonic. But you can run into problems there too, because some people, we start investigating, we realize that if they don't have a coffee or two every day, they don't have bowel movements. And their
Sure.
body is only having bowel movements because of the kind of stimulant effect of the caffeine. But on their own, they're actually quite backed up. And then we need to do some investigation. Why isn't their gut moving food along appropriately on its own?